What's good, YouTube? This is Very Mellow Man, and welcome back to my Let's Play of Yakuza 5 Remastered. So, first episode, Kiryu is now a taxi driver with a new identity, living as far away from Morning Glory as possible, and we don't know why. At least not yet. Also, Haruka appears to be an idol. Again, we don't know why. But that's not really relevant today. I just need to catch you up for the sake of continuity. Because today we're going to be taking on the Sosuke Komaki School of Tiger Fist. If you're wondering how I have so much money, it's because I sold the two golden plates we got for playing with Yakuza save data. And I've got a dozen stamina double X's from the Ebisu Pawn Shop. Two places taken care of at once. Let's just take care of this out the way. The trainers are gonna be their own video for this Let's Play.
Yeah.
We're not gonna stuff them in the same. We're not gonna do whole videos covering side content like we did in Yakuza 3 and 4. We're gonna just make everything your own video. Well, we got that out of the way pretty early. Kiryu calls it like he sees it. Really, Sosuke. Yeah, I understand you. And he's not wrong to criticize. My performance in the Chapter 1 boss battle speaks for itself. And this is the game that introduces the prevention of activating heat moves. We got to do this in Kiwami and Kiwami 2, but for obvious reasons, Remastered 3 and 4 did not have this ability.
Ew.
I don't want to get beaten down by two opening mid-bosses ever again. Kiryu, you should know what the Komaki knockback is. Alright, fair enough. Fair enough. Anyway, I have my suspicions confirmed about the engine for this game. The engine here is, in fact, the Yakuza 0 and Yakuza Kiwami engine. More specifically, the engine for this game was first developed and playtested with the Yakuza Ishii spinoff game. Very similar to how Very similar to how, in preparation for Yakuza 3, another Yakuza. Another Yakuza game. Yakuza 3. Basically, the Yakuza spin-off games that take place in feudal Japan that play like Nio, for what it's worth. The Ishin and Kenzan spin-off games are used to test the new Yakuza engines for the other games, so as their quality will be better. Knockbacks are really useful in Kree to attack. And we relearned the Komaki knockback. But he's getting old. On the way up, he's on the way down. Yeah. Interesting subtitle for this game. The Legend of the Dragon of Dojima has grown old. And I wonder if aging is going to play a part in this game's themes. I know for a fact, he's still one of the toughest opponents in the Coliseum, after all. Basically, he's warning you about the revenge counter that bosses in Japanese action games like this in Kingdom Hearts tend to have. Hit them enough times, they'll automatically parry your block attack. Really? So we just hyper guard each other. Luckily, I can still use healing items. All right, Ultra Throw. Nice. Yeah, so say you're not gonna learn about Kiryu's Yakuza Pass anytime soon. You should see what the Dragon Palace, I do imagine. Yeah, there's no reason for Komaki to move out of the Dragon Palace since it's got home, food, shelter, and a lot of students to teach. So, inventing Sosuke is a better idea since Kiryu's not living in Kamurocho right now.
Bill.
All right. R1 and circle, of course. Which means that we can't use it on him yet, but in the next training session we'll be able to get to it. Cool. So yeah, I like that when the training missions have a story in them, because you get character development out of the whole thing. There it is. This is really the only thing you can do. Oh god. The increasing health bars makes sense, but I'm gonna try to get all the lessons in this one video, especially because we got the parry. Oh my god. Now, the parry isn't gonna be as strong in this game, because I don't think we're gonna be getting Dragon King Essence back. Good looks have nothing to do with it, but as long as you're on the subject, are you a pastor good looking these days? It's 2012, Kiryu, he pretty much is by Japanese standards. Yeah, Kira, your style of Japanese manliness is literally out of date at this point. But they're not into you specifically, is what Kira was getting at. Oh my god. All right, fine. Demoralization opens up everyone's guard. Hey, got a Torah Knight. Thank you for the trouble. Right, the Club Segas are always the purple buildings. I need to... No matter how many times I play these games, I always feel like I need to rely on the map. It's kind of weird. There you are. I was admired once growing up, but obviously the people who did admire me don't do that anymore. We're just kind of there. Fine, drunk. Okay. Take this one when we're drunk. Might as well get that too. Alright. Alright then. The taxi cab up here is faster. Keep running. Oh my god. This is why I hate the lack of a sprint button. I'm actually kind of astounded at the fact that Yakuza 0 the Yakuza 0 is the game that introduced the sprint button. Because using walk to bypass ram encounters is not really fun. And this is the Komaki tire drop, the legendary Komaki tire drop. No, it's not. Basically, in order to beat him in this mode, we need to just basically focus on grabbing. And that's the tiger. That can KO us if we're not careful.
Get in there!
And we have our legendary tire drop back. Yeah, it looks like your stupid ageism is actually quite stupid, huh? So what's your issue, dude? Oh. Grant parental abandonment. Yeah, we learned in Kiwami that he traveled the world to fight people, so he had to be homeless in order to make that feasible. Time for the final lesson. Conceptual attacks. Nice. Okay. We will have a way of tapping under magical power in the backs of the wall. We'll be able to do that at will. It would be a huge advantage. The fact that you can use Swaki style move shows you trained your soul technique and body. That means you should be able to tap into this off-the-charts power when you're back to a corner, just like me. Off-the-charts power. Alright, Giggle's going off, so we're free to use anything we want, including the tiger drop. Let's rock.
Okay.
Yeah! Perfect way to finish the training. Bet your ass it did. Ultimate Essence Climax Heat. Alright. Thank you, man. Thanks, Sosuke. Face off for real. Know something about you, Master? You're not your full potential, huh? Arouse more violence than martial arts. If Master wipes out yourself, your form would be clear, you'd be able to put your heart and soul to each technique. I don't sense that you're in fighting, you're assuming you're holding back. Oh, you just want Komaki's approval. Interesting. Okay. Pretty much. Chip on his shoulder because you just want him to notice you. That makes a lot more sense. I'm just pointing at the obvious. You just thought we wanted to do. But remember, the more you resort to violence, the further you stray from your grandfather's path. That's all to say. Oh, we complete all the Sosuke training options. Cool. So we gotta leave and come back to finish. We finished the training, but we aren't finished with Sosuke's story arc. And we're not necessarily done learning things from him. Oh, I guess we are actually done with him for now, because what we need to be able to go back to Kamurocho to do, and that's not going to happen for a while. So, thank you guys for watching. If you liked this video, leave a like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys next time for even more Kiryu adventures.